I'm going to be working.
Nice to see you. Thank you for coming.
It's familiar in India, the
Nate, where are you? Oh, there you are.
It's abandoned. Yes, please. Take a lot of pictures. I realized from the trip I need to. Diane will be here.
Okay.
And Jacqueline Chu, who's in the other room.
Okay.
And I just sent you their name.
That's okay.
That's great. And
do a video on YouTube in a couple of days.
Thank you. I think I've seen you around at our events before.
Yeah.
Thank you so
much.
Yes, they agreed to do that. But they're not going to be
classes.
classes. I see Nella Manuel here, who was once a student at City College in the horticulture department. You know what she's doing now? She runs the People's Garden down the street at McAllister. From the City College of San Francisco to feed her community here in the Tenderloin. So without further ado, we would like to call on some speakers who will attest to the fact that we need to keep this campus, because, you know, a campus is not just a building, it's the students that make the building. It's not just the bricks, there's a mortar that keeps the bricks together. We'd like to introduce former assembly member of District 17, a friend of the working people, the friend of the poor, the friend of the people, the champion, a longtime champion for City College of San Francisco, none other than Mr. Tom Amiano.
Thank you very much, Mabu High. You know, I think some of you know I taught in this building many years ago. I also taught at 33 Gough Street. I taught ESL, and a lot of my students now speak with a New Jersey accent. However, it did enable them to get employment, to send their kids to school. We talked about inequality, economic inequality. Well, when we keep having arbitrary acts like this, not notifying people, I understand there's going to be some classroom space provided. But how did this happen? Why did it happen so last minute? Where is the mayor's office on this? This is about development of these sites. Don't let anybody kid you. And we need the board to be reseated, because without them, there is no oversight. And this would not have happened in the way that it should happen. I'd like the mayor to sign on. To a few bills in Sacramento that really urge the reinstatement of the board. I understand that we've made some progress, and it could be July, but what are the strings that are attached? In the meantime, the extraordinary powers, what does that mean? They're from outer space? What does that mean? It means no transparency. It means closing buildings on a moment's notice. It means defranchising our students. So I tell you, this is emblematic. This isn't just about a building, as the gentleman said. This is about the spirit, the beauty, the treasure of City College. And we need these buildings to stay open, to be accessible to the disabled, to be earthquake-proof. We don't need to be shuttled off to some building a few blocks away. And what does that mean? What other buildings will they be closing? 33 Gough is very, very lucrative for developers. Do we have a say in that? No. So we need to insist that there be transparency, that there be inclusion, and we need to sit the Board of Trustees back in their seats, elected democratically. And if they fall on their swords, we'll kick them out. But we don't need Sacramento or people who are divorced from the spirit of San Francisco to remove them. That is not democracy. That is oppression. Si se puede.
Many students, when they got here at the start of school, were met by a notice saying that we are closed. Now, what is that from a institution like City College that has been here for such a long time? What message does that send? There have been people that have had to go to different parts of town to attend classes. As we know, ESL has always been an important part of the curriculum of City College of San Francisco, particularly this campus, the City College of San Francisco Civic Center ESL, or Civic Center campus. We'd like to bring up a student who's a former ESL student at this campus who had to move to the Chinatown campus because of all this. We'd like to welcome Jacqueline Chu.
For 4 years. awesome. Yeah. Teachers are, our teachers are excellent. And they have been nice to students. We have also, we have respected our teachers. Monday, no, in January, I was surprised because our campus closing down temporarily for seismic repair. One day on the spring semester, I couldn't believe it because sudden closure. You know what?
Watch out.
How come zero classes ahead? The spring,
we have a gentleman here from the Community Housing Partnership who has a relationship with this campus. He took computer classes that enriched his work, enriched his knowledge base. And we'd like to welcome him here now, Mr. Dwayne Sears. He's a leader with Community Housing Partnership. Dwayne.
Ever since I've been here in my 35 years, we've always had education here. Why to take it away? It's the speed of time. So, keep it open.
Right on.
Also recognize the Arc of San Francisco there here in the house today. I was an alumni of City College of San Francisco. Believe it or not, I was there for decades because I believe in taking my time. And I got to tell you, what I did was I was in the broadcasting department. The skills that I gleaned from City allowed me to work in the media. And then my plan was to go to San Francisco State University. And you know what I found out when I got to SF State?
What?
That City College was just as good, and in a lot of ways, better than SF State. So we have to make sure that City College is around for our children and our grandchildren.
Keep it open!
Keep it open! So I mentioned earlier that ESL is a big part of this campus, as well as the other campuses within the City College of San Francisco system. We'd like to call on a member of the faculty, a member of AFT 22121, a longtime ESL teacher at the Civic Center campus, a very active member of the City College of San Francisco Faculty Union, and she will talk about the impact of closure on students. We'd like to welcome Diane Wallace.
It's been heartbreaking for us to not have our community together here. And just as an update, we've all been thrown into the diaspora, as we say, half of us in Chinatown, half of us at Mission. And what that has resulted in is about three quarters of our students are not attending classes anymore. In my 115 class, I now have 5 or 6 students instead of 25 or 30 students. Same thing in my 315 class, I had 8 students yesterday, and I normally would have 20 something. So it's really had an impact. It's really hurting CCSF's enrollment, and we need to, at this time more than ever, to get our enrollment up. We also feel like the faculty and the students have really been shut out of the whole process of knowing what's going on and communicating with administration. We have several faculty members that have been appointed to a committee to be responsible for finding an alternative property temporarily, and there's been almost no communication with that committee until very recently. So we're very concerned about that. And we need to find a place in the Civic Center Tenderloin area. We need to keep access open. A lot of our students are working adults. They have time maybe 1 or 2 hours a day to come to class before work, after work, after they drop their children off. And we need to keep access open for those working adults. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So right now what we're going to do is...
¡Unidos que seremos! ¡Unidos que seremos! a member of the Board of Supervisors, I'm Eric Marr from the Richmond District, District 1. I'm here with David Campos from District 9. And we thank Jane Kim as well from District 6 to be here with a common voice from the three of us, but also with all of you, that we're going to continue to build the strength of our coalition to save City College, but to really empower not only the students, but also the faculty and the staff as well of the institution. We haven't heard from you for a little while, but when the administration announced abruptly as a slap in the face to people that they were going to close the Tenderloin campus, that was a slap that was heard very loudly here. Now you're building the coalition again, and you refuse to be silenced, and I'm so proud to be here with you as you march from the campus to City Hall. I join with you to say we want our campus back, and the Tenderloin needs its community college campus. The multilingual spine and the chance and your spirit of unity is beautiful. It's something that should be reproduced here at City Hall as you raise your voice and your power. Also, we wanted to say that with Supervisor Campos, Kim, and I, that the hearing that we have called, we will make sure that your voice is heard loud and clear, and that we join you in holding the administration accountable at City College. Your demands for bringing the classes back and fast-tracking the repairs are heard here loud and clear as well, and reopening the campus as soon as possible. The other demand of finding temporary classrooms for all the classes disrupted is a good one. I'd like to hear more of what you're recommending to the administration. I wanted to just join you lastly to say, before Supervisor Campos comes up, don't slam the door on the students. Don't close the City College campus. Thank you for being strong and building the coalition. Thank you, Supervisor Jane Kim, for your leadership. You know, I'm actually pretty sick and tired of being sick and tired about what's happening at City College. I don't know about you, but it just seems like every single day it's one fight after another. And I know that, you know, there are a number of folks out there who feel, well, you know, maybe we should try a different tactic. You know, we know there's a new special trustee that came in. And I don't know, but I'll tell you this. These folks are working against the interests of our community. They are working against the interests of the students. And at the end of the day, the proof is in the pudding. Because they closed this campus without any community input, without any say from the teachers, without any say from the students. And I think that we need to send a very clear message that, yes, we appreciate the fact that this new trustee said, you know, in 4 months they're going to give power back to the elected trustees. 4 months is way too long. We want power today. The people of San Francisco to have a say over their own future, over the future of this institution, because this institution is San Francisco. We are City College. You are City College. I am City College. And we're not going to stand by while this administration continues to turn its back on the community. And we want to ask not just the Board of Supervisors. We want our mayor's office. We want the entire city government to say, enough is enough. Power back to the people today. Thank you.
I think Supervisor Campos put it best when he said he's tired of being tired. We're not going to sit idly by when we're seeing the gentrification not only of our neighborhoods, but the attempted and incessant struggle and fight to gentrify our education as well. La Voz Latina is an organization, a group that serves Latina families in the Tenderloin neighborhood for a very, very long time. And one of the representatives, Miriam is going to come up and talk about why the Civic Center City College of San Francisco campus matters to La Voz. Miriam.
Hi. Hola, buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Miriam. Pertenezco a La Voz Latina de Tenderloin y soy estudiante del City College.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is Miriam. I'm part of La Voz Latina and I'm a student at City College.
Agradezco a todos mis compañeros por asistir a esta convocatoria, porque veo en cada uno de nosotros clamando justicia y solidaridad. Somos gente de fe que confía en la verdad y sabemos que donde terminan las palabras comienza la verdad.
Thankful to see all of my compañeros here today because I see in all of you the fight for justice and the fight for solidarity. We are believing people and we believe that where words end and actions begin is where we will see the truth.
I didn't have too much money, but came straight from the street. They gave me an opportunity to get educated for free. They gave me grants. They gave me books. They gave me tuition, just like what everybody else wants, just so they can get educated. I am that youngster. I am that product. 20 years later, I'm in my neighborhood, and I run a violence prevention program with my people right here that we own our own building. What am I trying to say? What am I trying to say is this. When you don't give opportunity to people who are low income, immigrants, gay, lesbian, queer, anybody, man, from who we... the people from the hood, you would never see the leadership from the people if they continue to try to shut and close the door. That's why it's super important for us to stand for what we believe in and keep these classes and these schools open. Don't believe the hype that they say they ain't got no money. They got money. They got money because they building jailhouses to lock us up. So it's important that we keep, you know, you keep your mind set open to what's happening and you stand up for it, because they want to disrupt classes and they want to disrupt us. Have us go against each other and make it seem like education ain't key. Education is important, not just for kids, but for seniors and everybody in between, because education will get you where you need to go. You got an army right here with our people, the United Players. Even though we from the South the market, we get out and we rock and we roll anywhere when it stands for justice. So we're here with you guys. We want to thank y'all again. Let's keep these campuses open. Let's open up all kind of classes for everybody. Whether it's English classes, math classes, people got to learn to read and write at a proper level. And that's us right here. And they should be free.
Members of Sprinkle throughout this great coalition. I just want to remind everybody that the Labor Council is going to continue to be in on the fight, no matter what it is, to make sure that City College is fully restored, fully strengthened, fully funded, and classes are open for everybody. Labor Council is here. Whose campus? Whose campus? All right. The Vietnamese community in the Tenderloin is a very vital community. It depends and relies on City College and the services of the Civic Center City College campus to serve their community. Dennis Nguyen is a community organizer at the Vietnamese Youth Development Center. He'll talk about how the Vietnamese community relies on the Civic Center campus. Dennis Nguyen.
Good afternoon. I was asked to give a speech this morning, so I wrote up something really formal. I hope you guys don't mind me reading it. Dear City Supervisor, my name is Dennis Nguyen, and I'm one of the staff members at the Vietnamese Youth Development Center. We, the staff, the youth, the family members at BYDC are deeply concerned over the recent closure of CCSF in the Tenderloin. The closure of the Tenderloin campus this has already made a tremendous impact on many of our youth and families. Many of our youth are recent monolingual immigrants, and they are from extremely low-income families. They live in the Tenderloin, a poverty-stricken area, and attend CCSF Tenderloin campus because commuting outside of the area would put their family an extra burden on the time and the financial means. Many of the youth in the Tenderloin are gifted, but they face numerous obstacles that prevent them from reaching their full potential. The CCSF in the Tenderloin is imperative resources for many of these youth to develop their talents and skills. This campus has offered many of the courses that help people in our community become fluent in English and assimilate and culturate in our American society. This campus has also offered vital vocational school for them to obtain the necessary skills to earn a living. Historically, this campus has served as a vital resource for many Southeast Asian refugee immigrants to navigate our society. Moreover, this campus is not only crucial for our community, but also the working class community of African American, Latino, Middle Eastern, and Caucasian family in the neighborhood. Continues to be worse in terms of violence, substance, youth, high crime rate, and what have you among our youth that's already being disenfranchised. We sincerely ask that the city council, city supervisors, to do everything in their power to find the resources to keep the Tenderloin campus open so that our marginalized youth can have the resources for them to grow. Given a chance to contribute to society productively. Thank you.
I was thinking about some of my own memories of City College. In one of my last semesters there, I took a boxing class. They offered boxing, and I got into it. I got knocked down many times. But you know what?
And also, some students have not been able to pay the bus fare. So we tried to get bus fare for the students, and we got some small number of bus passes, $20, for an 18-week semester that doesn't give students a class every day. So there was some reasonable request on our part to help the students get to class. It never came to pass. We hear that more bus passes are coming, but we haven't seen them yet. And we would like to see those classes come to our students so they can come to school. Also, we have been trying to work with administration to find out where could we belong for 3 years, possibly 3 years, while they seismically retrofit and improve the school building, which would be wonderful. The school needs many, many improvements, and the students deserve to study in a good environment. And right now, it's not such a great environment. It's charming. We have usually 54 countries represented in our classrooms, and somehow with 14 languages in the classroom, we learn English together. They meet each other. They build a strong community. It's a microcosm of what we want to do in the world. We want to understand each other. We want to listen and learn from each other. And that's what we do at the Civic Center. So we want the administration to find us a home here in our neighborhood so students can come back in August. We want classes for adult learning. We want our LGBT classes back. We want to have a place like we did until we were closed for youth to come. We had a youth organization that was coming in the afternoons to participate in training for working in different entities here in San Francisco. They studied with us a couple of days. They came to City Hall. They went to the State Building. It was a perfect marriage of youth outreach for the community. We can't do that now because we're not in the building. And that's a shame. And that was the work of our dean working with community leaders. We want to be back here. And we want to be back fully what we are. We don't want any sneaky little thing where suddenly we're not ESL or not non-credit. Non-credit is more than ESL, and I often like to say it's not really a second language. You know, it's really English as another language. I mean, if you think about it, most of our students are learning their third or their fourth language. And if you think about a lot of Americans, we struggle just to learn a little bit of Spanish, maybe, or a little bit of Mandarin, and we don't do so well, some of us. Learning a language is such hard mental work. If you can speak two or three or four languages, I say congratulations to you. I'd like to say it in five languages, but I really can't. So in my class, we always try to learn. We learn hello, goodbye, thank you for the holidays. We learn happy new year. We learn I love you for Valentine's Day. In every language, we write it out on the board. All of this is a beautiful community building thing. It's not expensive. In fact, I just want to close by passing out a pencil for some of you who are close enough. This one says, I learn English on Eddy Street.
Eddy Street!
The other pencil says, English opens doors for me. So English opens doors. Open our doors, don't close them. Thank you.
Okay, I'd like to make an announcement. If anybody needs a pencil sharpener, I have one in my back pocket, and I'll try not to sit down. Okay, our next speaker works with Senior and Disability Action. Our organization works with seniors and people with disabilities. We know that...
Officials should go there and take classes there. They can learn about our city and what we need, and if they experience it too. Because some of them don't know anything about our city, and they are selling our city to all kind of, you know, corporations, and they forget about us. And you know, for us, this college represents a lot. Me particularly, you know, I graduated from City College and I transferred to San Francisco State where I got my BA and my master. And you know, stories like that, there are many. There are many stories like that. You know, my classmate, she went on and she got her PhD. And she's teaching at Ohio University. You know, this is City College. This is the tools that we get when we come here as immigrants with no English, because when I came here, you know, I was 25, I didn't know the language, and I was afraid of learning it. I was like, I'm gonna look like a fool, you know, and I didn't want it to go. But then I discovered,
real quick, I mean, I know that all the stories you've heard today already just talk about the importance of not just City College, but particularly the Civic Center campus. And I just want to reiterate that who we see being impacted is the most vulnerable people in our city, right? The folks who need City College the most are the ones right now who are not able to enter City College campus, right? So I think we need to recognize that it's, you know, the immigrants, older adults, you know, seniors, folks who are, you know, even entire families, right? Because we know the whole family goes to City College, from high school students who might take classes at City College to their parents who might take a vocational training class or ESL class to their grandparents, right? Who might be taking Tai Chi lessons. So we know that City College, it affects everybody and every family in San Francisco. And the closure of the campus, I think, really scares me. Because what does it mean if we let Civic Center campus close in this way or shut down indefinitely? What does this mean for all the other campuses and all the other neighborhoods, right? That's in the Bayview, that's in the Mission, that's in Chinatown, that's all across our city. So we cannot let this be an example of how, you know, the administration is going to shut down campuses without giving notice to people, without thinking about what's the impact on our families, right? And, you know, we work with City College, SCPA, and also with Chinese Firm Affirmative Action to work on these kind of programs that change people's lives. We know that programs that help low low-wage workers who aren't making the minimum wage right now, who can't even afford to pay, you know, their rent, even though they're working two jobs. Those are the types of workers that that City College is serving to help them learn English to get a better job at a union hotel, right?
Yeah.
Helps them with their resume, helps them get training for interviews. And this is the type of program that we can't, you know, that demonstrates who City College is for, right? So I just want to say thank you all for being here today, and that we're in this fight together, and we're not going to let the Civic Center campus close down in this way or shut down in this way. We're going to demand that the mayor and the city and the administration takes is held accountable for that. So,
yeah.
Thank you all. So first, as we already mentioned, there's petitions. There's over 2,000 petitions that have been gathered today. And a delegation of District 6 residents, teachers, and students are all meeting over here to deliver those petitions to Supervisor Kim, who's working, as I understand it, with Supervisor Mar and Campos on legislation that's going to help the Civic Center campus. So if folks want to get up over here, and if maybe we just want to close with a chant today.
Yeah.
So I'm going to ask you, whose city? And you're going to say, our city, right? So whose city?
Our city!